Hi there, hello and welcome to Let's Play SimCity 4. So one of the few things that I want to try on this channel is doing a commentary gameplay for SimCity 4. So here we are. And before we jump into the game, a few things that I want to note are I'm going to play with lots of plugins or mods installed. Mainly I have Network Add-on Mod and Colossus Add-on Mod. And second, I'm not really an expert into this game, at least not yet, but I will try to explain what I'm trying to do and maybe give some tips and tricks for a beginner SimCity 4 player. And last, I can't promise this going to be a long running series yet. I will look how this video perform first and decide based on that. So if you want to see this gameplay turn into a long series, hit the like button and help me reach 1k subs by subscribing to the channel. With that being said, let's jump into the game. Alright, this is our usual New York region, and I'm going to play on these large tiles because there will be a lot of space that we can build on, and also there's no directly connected city for these tiles, so there's no effect on our RCI demand, and this is will be like similar to playing on an empty region. So this is our city and we are currently on guard mode. When starting a new city, I usually like to start by looking around the terrain and to see where I can put my buildings. And I also like to plan where my main networks will go. By main networks, I mean like the highway or maybe railways network, or even just a regular roads or maybe avenue that will go to outside, to connect to the outside of this city. And for this tile, we can see that we have like clips that goes diagonally like here and also here, and seems like we have this large area that we can use to build our maybe like the main area for our city. And then this is also that we can use to build here, and we can use maybe like the top. This is looks like a small hills that we can use maybe like our farm town or yeah, rural town, something like that. And since if you remember from the region view, we have actually city diagonally like this here, and also large tile here. I would like to maybe like build a connection, start from here and go through the middle like here and up to the other large tiles, because yeah, my future city I will try to build on that tile. So yeah, it would be nice to have main networks that goes from bottom left here to top right here. So without further ado, we can jump to mayor mode. We'll need to set the name for our city first, and I will go with Bekasi for this one. Taruh for the mayor name, and I will choose easy for the difficulty level so that we can start with 500k for the starting money. And let's establish our city. We have some nice fireworks going on, but let's play, let's pause the gameplay first. And I would like to start by placing our main network first, so we go down here and I'll be choosing a railways network, so press T to select the railways network, and then maybe we can just connect it down here like that, and then maybe add some diagonal networks like that, so that later we can extend this through this diagonal and then connect it outside city like that. But for now, this should be good enough because we are going to build around this area first. Let's smooth this curve a little bit, and because we want to build around this area, so we can start placing our road network here and add some diagonal just to make it a little bit more interesting, and then go through here. Let's smoother the curve a little bit, and then maybe we can extend this route so that we can connect it to the outside, but add some diagonals just to make it more interesting. Now that we have got our main routes, let's provide utilities for our sims. First, let's provide the electricity, because zones, with the exceptions of the agriculture, won't grow in your city if they are not connected to a power source. And next, we need to supply them with water, because I believe medium and high well sims won't come into your city if they don't have access to it. So let's provide a water supply, and make sure they are all connected to source of water using the pipelines. And last, we need to take care of the garbage, because they can cause all sorts of problems, especially abandonment in your buildings. I often forgot about this one until I see some abandoned buildings in my city. So make sure to take care of this first, before you forgot. And I've got this garbage disposal mod. It's basically just throw the garbage at the edge of the tile. But if you are playing without mods, you will want to use these landfill zones. Alright, we took care of all of that. So now we can start building our city. And let's put a train station first. I'm going to use the usual rural depot, and it functions as passenger and freight station, so you will only need one of these. Looks pretty nice actually. And let's add some decorations near the stations. I love using these crossings because it looks nice. And then let's add a bus stop near the stations so your sims can travel to the station. And maybe we can add some trees to cover this area. Let's see if we can put a trees around this. Let's use this seasonal, maybe elders. Alright, I think that's enough. Let's put a street. I'm going to use this moonlight style street. This one. Let's try working on some, maybe like a parking area around this. Yeah, around the stations. Using this one. Okay, maybe that's too much. Let's see if we can fix this. Let's cover like that. Yep, I think we're good. And for the zones, I usually start by laying the street first, and then later manually zones the area by following the layout of the streets. But I'm not really strict about the order of the process, so sometimes when I already know that I want certain zones for an area like this one, I just go for it. So it's rather a back and forth process between placing your streets network and zoning the area. I also love to incorporate some diagonals and curve on my streets. I think they look nice, and it's possible to have them thanks to network add-on mod or NAM. And I'm thinking about having some kind of town center with commercial buildings around this area here, so maybe we need to adjust this road a little bit. Let's place a roundabout here, and add a road connection down here. Maybe we can even extend this all the way through here and have it connect to outside city like that. And I made this road diagonal instead of just a straight line like this because I want it to be longer than this railways. So later when we expand our area down here, our sims will prefer to use these railways because it will be faster than using this road. But keep in mind that this mechanics only works if you have NAM install, because sims will behave differently on vanilla games without NAM. And let's fix this road. Now we can continue working on our streets. I usually put the street tiles one at a time like this because I want to flatten the area while building the streets. So that's why you see a lot of tiles here. And let's have a 5x5 area here, and later we can use it as our big factory building. Alright, I think this is enough for now. We don't need too much to begin with. And let's fix this curve. And now we can start zoning our city. Let's place a passenger train station here, and I think I'm going to use the spam rural hall for this one right here. And don't forget to also put a bus stop near your station. And let's finish our zones. Maybe we can mix more commercial zones around this area here. And now that we fill most of the inner part, we can put farms on the outskirts of our city. and let's place our industrial zones here. And it's nice to have industrial zones near the edge of the tiles, so it will be shorter for the freighter to commute. Alright, I think we are done with our zones for now. Let's check the water pipeline to make sure everything covered with water. And last, before we start the simulations, I like to provide service buildings, especially educations, early on, because they will need some time to take effect. So the earlier you provide them for your sims, the faster you will get demand for high-tech industries and high-well commercial buildings like offices. So we put our elementary schools, high schools, and library, and let's also provide medical clinics. And let's put more bus stop to increase the usage of bus in our city. I think we are done with all the preparations, and so let's watch our city grow, shall we? I think we are looking pretty good. We got some nice farmhouses here. Let's replace this one with lesser trees, so just it won't look like a jungle in the middle of this area here. Look here, we already got some nice commercial buildings growing. Let's replace this one again. And I think this one is good enough, so let's preserve it. And let's have a look around and see what we can improve. Let's put some pedestrian malls along this tiles here. Also, as you can see, our budgets are bleeding right now because we haven't adjusted our service buildings like medical clinics and schools yet. And we might still got more expenses than income after we adjust our service buildings, but it's totally fine because we got so many cash that we can burn right now. But for now, let's adjust the budget for our service buildings. This house looks pretty nice, so I'll preserve it. Let's look around for more buildings that we can reserve. And also check the building style control. I want all styles at once and make sure everything check here. Let's add some green bars to reduce the air pollution around this area here. We need to adjust these zones a little bit. And I like to put some city ordinance to increase the effectiveness of our educations. Check the junior sports programs and pro reading campaign. And if we take a look around here, we can see that our education is already starting to take effect. And we even got ourselves a really nice buildings here. Let's have a look around for some more that maybe we can improve. And maybe we can fill this area with more houses. I don't really like the looks of this farm here. So let's try to get another one. Yep, that's a lot better. And let's try to fill this gap here. And let's crowd this area with some more houses. Alright, that's a lot better. So we are nearly close with our balance right now. And I'm going to look around for some more buildings that I can reserve or maybe replace, and maybe some adjustment that I can make. So I'll see you after I'm done with that. We still got a lot of demand for high-tech industry, so I think we can start building a big factory here. And with that, we managed to get rid all of the dirty industries around this area here. And if we check our demands, we can see that we got some demands for high-well commercial buildings, so let's try to work on that. We got some nice commercial buildings here, so let's preserve them. And maybe it's time to expand to the area down here. So let's start working on that. Let's put a train station. And some bus stops. And also don't forget to supply the water pipeline. Anyway, I actually forgot to put some police office and fire station. So let's put them right now. Alright, I'm done looking around and preserving buildings that I want to stay. And I think we can conclude this episode for now. So let's save our progress. So the game crashed while I'm trying to save our previous progress. And after sulking for a few days feeling devastated of the damage, I managed to redo everything and try to replicate what we have done previously. So here is our town right now. And let me give a quick tour of it. This is our industrial area here. And we got some big high-tech industry buildings. The difference from the previous one is now that we also have this big high-tech building here. And also this Polaroid buildings, this is a commercial building. We also have some mixed commercial and residential buildings around this area here. And here we have some detailing works with some decorations, bus stop, trees, and also pedestrian mall. This is the front view of the shops row. And this residential area here is similar to the previous one. It's just the buildings are now different. And here's the part of the town that I like the most. This is our town center here. We got so many nice commercial buildings. The difference from the previous ones are now we also have some nice apartments growing here and some commercial towers here, and we also have this nice apartment buildings. We also got this small apartment and some nice buildings along this road here. And this fancy nightclub with some crowds cheering and fighting in front of it, causing all this traffic jam here. And this residential area is similar to the previous one. It's just now we have this additional apartment building. This area here is also similar. We got some nice farmhouses here, but I place a different crossing for this one here. We've got a small shops on this corner here, and overall of this area here is pretty similar to the previous one. Let's check our industrial areas here. Here we have a nice manufacturing buildings, but overall else is just dirty industries and farms, so nothing really fancy yet. So that's it for our first build. This is just a small town, but I'm pretty satisfied with the end result, even though I have to redo everything again after the crash. Especially for this town center, we got so many nice commercial and residential buildings growing here. And I think that's it. We can conclude this build. I hope you like the build and the end result, and enjoy the gameplay as much as I enjoy building it. And if you do, please do me a favor by liking this video and subscribing to the channel if you haven't already, because this is still a very small channel, so every interactions that you do really helps a lot. And thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Bye bye.